Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this brief ceremony. I have with me here, of course, with the principal officers of the University of Nigeria. I have with me as well the executive directors of the Fidelity Bank of Nigeria, Mr. Nnamdi Okonkwo and his team all the way from Lagos. Fidelity Bank has had a long-standing relationship with the University of Nigeria, and as a very responsible organization, a responsible bank in Nigeria, they have tried to support our efforts to empower the youth of Nigeria. This time around, you can see in front of us computer workstations. There's supposed to be about 400 workstations here to make up our lab, both for training and all sorts of examinations for University of Nigeria, and in fact, the general society, Nigerian society, will leave it open for academic activities from the general society. And Fidelity Bank of Nigeria is, I don't want to preempt what they will say, but I heard for the grapevine that they want the computer lab to be named after Fidelity Bank. With all these implications. They already set up 100 powerful HP computers. And remaining the balance of 300, on the time there were 200 have been ordered, the balance from HP. And they should be here in the next few weeks. So I would prefer, let me not give up everything, let me allow the mouth, the horse. This is the one from the horse's mouth. And I'll hand over to you. Mr. Nnamdi Okonkwo, Executive Director of the Fidelity Bank of Nigeria.
Thank you very much, Prof. The Vice Chancellor and other senior executives of the university, my colleagues, members of the press, it's with great honor that we are here today to perform this brief ceremony, like the VC has said. Why are we doing this? We, in Fidelity, if you look around, you will see what Fidelity has done in terms of corporate social responsibility. Not just the formal one. We have even involved our staff in a program we call Fidelity Helping Hands Program, where our staff are encouraged to do something different in the environment where we operate. And for that particular program, staff on their own voluntarily pick a project, donate money, and then the university gives them a matching donation to do projects all over Nigeria, Nasarawa, Akwa Ibom, Benin, Nsukka, everywhere you look, you see Fidelity people doing something different, commissioning boreholes, renovating classrooms, health centers, and so many more. Now, that tells you where our hearts and thoughts lie. It's not about profit and loss. It's not just about balance sheet. It's not about profit and loss accounts, but it's about doing something differently. We are opening a branch in this campus shortly. In fact, it's ready. But even before we did that, we had planned to make sure that we become part of this university, the university's progress. The reformation that you see here, because it's easy to say these things, you're partnering with the university to do something. But I tell you, it has to do with leadership also. I know this story about when you sit in a church, the same choir, the same congregation, the same music, and they play a song and people are snoring. Then you take a second, shift your paradigm. The same church, the same choir, the same congregation, the same music, the same choristers, but a different choir master. They sing the same song and people clap. That's the way I like to liken what I've seen in this university. So, when you go around, you see that obviously there's a transformation going on. And that gladdens our hearts, because some of us, if you go to some of the schools you attended, primary school, secondary school, you weep. And with a country's poor